So hello students, I am an aptitude trainer from Department of Career Planning and Development, and today we are going to discuss the topic of seating arrangements. So basically, in seating arrangements there are total three type of questions which are asked by the examiner. So number one is your circular arrangements, number second is your linear arrangements, and number third is your rectangular arrangements. Moreover, the circular arrangements and the rectangular arrangements are similar to each other, but the difference is in their shapes. So let's see. So first of all, to do the question, you need to understand something about the linear, circular and rectangular thing. So if we talk about the linear arrangements, so in linear arrangements, basically there are two type of questions. We talk about the type number one. The type number one is a persons are sitting in a single row, and the type number second, in the person there are two rows are given and number of persons are sitting in this row and other number of persons are sitting in this row. So we're talking about the type number one, the person are sitting in a single row. So in this type of questions, let's see, there are two types again come. For to solve this type of question, you need to know the directions. Directions are like that one, that north, south, east and west. So basically we are dealing with the north and south directions. All the question is giving that all of them are facing towards the north direction. If all of them are facing towards the north direction, that means they are facing in this direction, which is our north direction. So if you are facing in the north direction, that means suppose there are certain persons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. If you're talking about the persons, they are facing towards north. So like this one, everyone is facing towards the north direction. And next part, if you're talking about the sum of any person, you pick any person. Suppose we have picked this person. Now, if you're talking about the direction of this person, because the question are giving like that, that suppose this one is your A. A is third to the right of B. So that means the position of B will be like this one. Position of B will be here, then the condition is satisfied that A is third to the right of B, means 1, 2 and 3. So how will you know that if they are, both of them are facing, or everyone is facing towards the north direction, that means the right hand side will be in this side to A. With respect to A, right hand side is this side, and with respect to A, left hand side is this one. Same is the case with B. For B, left hand side is this one, right hand side is this one. Same is the case with rest of the people. So this is the type number one, where all of them are facing in the same direction. Same is the case with south direction. Let's see the another case, when all of them are facing towards the south direction. So again, let's say there are random number of persons are there and everyone is facing towards the south direction. So in that case, if you're talking about the direction right or left, now, as you can see that the direction with respect to north is opposite, which is the south direction. So their positions will be also changed. Now, in that case, so I'm writing again here as a A, here again as a B. If you're talking about A, then the right hand side of A is in this direction and the left hand side is in this direction, as they have changed their positions from north. When talking about the north, right is in right hand side. If you're talking about the south, right is in its left hand side. According to us, it is in left hand side. So same is the case with B. According to B, again left is this one and right is this one. So in this way, we are going to solve the questions of linear arrangements of type number one, when everyone is facing towards the same direction. Let's move to the type number two, where two rows are given. This one is your row number one and this one is your row number 2. Now, if the question is given that the row number 1 is facing towards the south direction, that means they are facing like this one, whatever the number of persons are given. So this was the case, and row number 2, those who are sitting in the row number second, they are facing towards the north direction. So that means whatever the numbers are there, the arrow will be like this one, they are facing towards the north direction. Now, as per the question again, saying that according to this person, right hand side is this side and left hand side is this side. According to these row persons, here it should be a right hand side and here it should be a left hand side. So this was the thing, the cases of the linear arrangements. Let's see one more thing, the cases of the circular arrangement. So in the case of circular arrangements, again there are two type of questions. The type number one, just suppose the circle is given, the person number of persons are circle, and type number two, again the number of persons are again sitting in a circle. But the difference between them is, number one, the condition is given that all of them are facing towards center. And in the type number 2, all of them are facing outwards the center, that means facing outside the center. So in that case, again things are simple like this one. The number of persons are sitting, we don't know how many persons are sitting, we are taking a random number like this one. Here again a random persons. So this was the case. Now suppose, now in this one, all of them are facing towards center, that means the arrow will become like this one. And all of them are facing outwards the center, that means they are sitting like this one. Now as per the question, we are talking about the according to the question, the thing is given in the right hand side or in the left hand side. So if we are talking about this person, let's name that person as A. We are talking about A. So according to the A, the right hand side will be in which direction? According to the A, right hand side will be here, and according to A, the left hand side will be here. If you talk about this person, suppose this person is your B. Now as you know, this person is facing towards the north direction, this person is facing towards the south direction. So in case of B, the right hand side will be here and the left hand side will be here. Same is the case with this person. Suppose this person is your C. This person is your C. So right hand side will be here, left hand side will be here. If we are talking about the this person, suppose this person is your D. Again the right hand side will be here, left hand side will be here. If we are talking about this person, this one is your E. Right hand side will be here, left hand side will be here. Now we will go to the A, the position change. That means the position from north, the position has been changed towards the south. So that's why the, according to the A, the right hand side will be here and the left hand side will be here and so on like this one. For this person, again the left hand side is here, right hand side is here and so on like this one. So for this person, right hand side is here, left hand side is here, right hand side is here, left hand side is here, right hand side is here, left hand side here. So in this way we are going to solve the question. For outer ones again this one is the same case. For this person, right hand side is here, left hand side is here, as you already know. For this person, this one is your left, this one is your right. So in this way we are going to arrange the questions in circular arrangements. Let's move to the last type. Last type is your rectangular arrangements. So in rectangular arrangement, this is a more or a similar than a circular arrangement. First, the difference is in their shapes. Again, there are two types, type number one, type number two. In this type of questions, we will construct a rectangle here to solve our questions. Now, again, the condition are same. All of them are facing towards the center. All of them are facing towards the center. And in the second part, all of them are facing outwards the center. Now again the things are same. If you are talking about the person, some of them are sitting in the corner. This was the different thing than the circle. That some of them are sitting in the center of the row, some of them are sitting in the corners. So in this way we are going to arrange them. Suppose there are two persons sitting in the centers, then we will construct two lines, again two lines. But the difference is that that not more than one person will be sit at any of the corners in case of the rectangular arrangements. So this was the case. Again, they are facing towards the center. Again, we will draw the with respect to their position, their foot direction, that is the right hand side and the left hand side. We are talking about this person, then the right hand side will be here and left hand side will be here. Same is the case with this person, as this person has faced towards the north direction and these persons are facing towards the south direction. So for them, this one is the, this direction is the left hand side and this direction is the right hand side. And in case of this one, all of them are facing towards outward, that means this one and this one. This is the case of vice versa of this position. That means we are talking about this one, this is their right hand side, this one is their left hand side, this one is the left hand side, this one is the right hand side. So this is the all concepts of sitting arrangements. Let's move to the questions from here.
Okay, so let's get start to solve the questions. So this is your question number one. The question number one says that the direction A, B, C, D, E, F and G are sitting in a circular region. So thing is given that they are sitting in a circular region. So let's construct a circle first. Then all are playing the cards. If all of them are playing the card, that means it is given in the question that everyone is facing towards the center of the circle. So let's see how many persons are given to us. Number of persons given to us are A, B, C, D, E, F and G. G means 7, so total number 7 number of persons are given to us. So let's construct the 7 lines, those who are representing the first persons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, and everyone is facing towards the center of the circle. So this was the thing. Okay, so let's see, the first statement says that F is second to the right of G. So you don't know where F will sit, where the G will sit. So the thing is given, F is second to the right of G. So let's suppose G is here. If G is here, F is second to the right of G. So right of G will be in this direction, second, that means here. So F will be here. So move to the next part of the question. Next part says that B is the neighbor of F. B is the neighbor of F but not of C. So there are two conditions here, either B could be here or B could be here. So we have to construct two cases. Let's name this one as case number 1 and this one as case number 2. So let's construct the circle here. So this one, let's place the persons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and the 7th one. Now the position of G and F is already fixed. Let's assume B is here in this case. Let's assume B is here in this case, which is a neighbor of F but not a neighbor of C. Okay, but not of C. So next part, E is the neighbor of C and is sitting 4th at the right of G. So right of G and 4th position, that means G is here. So 1, 2, 3, 4th position here, and that position is filled for A. According to this one, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this position is for A and E is the neighbor of C. So E is the neighbor of C. According to this case, C could be here. And according to this case, again there are two possibilities, either C could be here or C could be here. So let's assume that C is here and I am marking with a different pen. Let's select black pen, that this is the position of C. So as we can know that there are two positions of C. Okay, let's see the another one. D is between E and A. D is between E and A. So as for this one, D is between E and A. So as you can see that from the diagram, that where could be the D? Now as you can see that there are two possibilities of C. So D is between E and E. That means either this could be possible, D is between this one or E, D, A. So there are two possibilities to solve this. So let's assume, as you can see, that this position can be filled by only here if you remove from C from here, because only here the three positions are left, two positions are left with near to E. So let's rub this one, and this one is our case. So that means D should be in center, D should be in center, and this position is for A. So that means this case does not follow and this one will be follow. So let's erase this one. Okay, now we have construct the diagram here. Now as we have construct the diagram here, so let's solve the questions. The question number one says that who is fourth at the left of G? So fourth at the left of G, G is here and the left direction is in this direction. So fourth position, 1, 2, 3, 4. So our answer will be option number C. So let's move to the second question. The second question says that who is at the left of G? So according to this one, as you can see, left of G is here. Left of G is A. So our answer will be A. Now next question says that who is the neighbor of F? Who is the neighbor of F? F is here and the neighbor of F are C and B. So our answer will be option number D, which is C and B. So in this way we are going to solve our questions of sitting arrangement in case of circular arrangements. We have to construct as many as cases which are possible to construct the, all the cases to solve our questions. Let's the difference between circle, rectangle and square is this one. In terms of circle, you can place the persons according to yourself where you want, according to the number of persons. But in case of rectangle, the examiner will fix the positions of some persons. He can say that some of them are sitting in the corners. So you have to sit some of them at the corners. And the examiner could say that no one is sitting in the corner. Some of them, there is suppose that three of them are sitting in the longer line, that means this one. So you have to draw like this one, and one on the shorter line, that means this one and this one. Same is the case with square. Now in case of square, again same thing, you could be say that the number of persons sitting at the corner are facing towards the center, that means this person are sitting here and these are facing towards the center, and then one person is sitting on the adjacent side and those persons are facing towards outward the center. So that means those persons will be sit like this. So these are the all cases of rectangle and square with respect to the circle. Things are same, but in case of circle no restrictions are there, that's why. Okay let's move to the next question. Okay, so next question says that a certain number of persons were sitting in a circle facing towards the center. Now, in this question, this thing is not mentioned that how many persons are there. Thing is mentioned that the certain number of people were sitting in a circle. Now, this thing is given that they were sitting in a circle and all of them are facing towards the center. So, this is a case of simple that everyone is facing towards the center. So, now, next part. Some of the persons' arrangement are known. Okay. So first thing is given, A was sitting fourth to the left of. You don't know what is the position of A. Well, so let's construct here. Let's assume that here, as per the statement says that A was sitting fourth to the left of B. So let's assume that B is here. If B is here, B will face towards the center, and the left hand side of B is this direction, and A is fourth with respect to B. So there are 1, 2, 3. And fourth position is for the A. So next line says that J was sitting seventh to the right of A. J was sitting seventh to the right of A. Now A is here and A is facing towards the center. So seventh position with respect to A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. This position is for J, as J was sitting 7th to the right of A. Now next statement says that the number of persons sitting between A and B. Okay, how many persons are there? 1, 2, 3 persons are there. Was same as the number of persons sitting between A and F. So now there is same difference between A and B and A and F. So F should be in the left hand side of A and the difference of number was 1, 2, 3. That means there are again are 3 peoples between A and F. So 1, 2, 3. So this position is fixed for F. Okay. So next statement says that J was the neighbor of D. Okay. J was the neighbor of D. That means D should be here. D could be here or D could be here. So next statement says that who? That means D sits at the 7th position from F, which is the left of F. So 7th position of F and is a neighbor of J. That means D will be here and the number of persons between D and F are 6. Then only we can say that D is 7th position left of F. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now every position has been filled because the statement I have completed. Now next part of the question, the number of persons sitting between F and M was the same as the number of persons sitting between M and D. That means we have given F and D. As we can know the positions of F and D, F is here and D is here. The statement says that the number of persons between F and M was same as the number of persons sitting between M and D. That means M will be lies in the center of F and D. So there are two possibilities, either M could be here or M could be here. So these are the two possibilities. So let's see, can we place M in this part? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 positions are left. We cannot place M in between F and D. Suppose we have placed M here, then the difference of persons is 2 here. M and F and M, number of persons are 2. In between M and D, number of persons are 3. So that means that could not be possible. So we have to make M here. We have to set M in between this line. So difference between F and D is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This was the difference. So 11 difference, that means we have to place in the sixth position. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is the position of M. Now let's count 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So number of persons between F and M are 5. Number of persons between M and D is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That means our conditions have been fulfilled. Now next statement says that K was the neighbor of J. So K was the neighbor of J, that means K would be here because this position has been already occupied by D. So next statement says that M is not the immediate neighbor of A, and M is not the immediate neighbor of A because one position is left between M and A. So that means this one is the our final, this one is the our final diagram of this statement. Now as you already know, if you construct this diagram, it is easier to solve the questions. Let's see what are the questions of this particular question. Okay, so this was the diagram which I have already made earlier. Okay, let's see the question number one. Question number one says that what is the position of M with respect to A? Okay, what is the position of M with respect to A? Okay. So position of M with respect to A, there could be a two answers. You have to go with the options. What are the options given? I will tell you what was the first possible case, that M is one position right of A, because right of A is this one and second to the right of A. This could be our answer, or our answer could be M, position of M is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17th to the left of A. So this could be a two answers. You have to go with options. What is option given? You have to mark this one. Now the option in this particular question was second to the right. So I have marked this one is the right answer. Okay, let's see the number. Next question. Next question says that how many persons were sitting in a circle? So total number of persons, you have to count the total number of persons. So total number of persons are 19. Okay, next statement says that how many known persons were sitting between A and J when counting from left of A? So when counting from left of A, how many persons are sitting between A and J which are known? So A and J नॉन पर्संस आर एफ एंड डी. सो आवर आंसर विल बी टू. नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट, हु सिट सेकेंड टू द राइट ऑफ बी. ओके, बी इज हियर, हिज राइट पोजिशन इज दिस डायरेक्शन, सेकेंड पर्सन इज के. सो आवर आंसर विल बी के. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन सेज दैट हु सिट सेकेंड टू द राइट ऑफ ए. सो सेकेंड टू द राइट ऑफ ए, आवर आंसर विल बी एम. सो एम इज अवर आंसर. ओके, सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ अ लीनियर अरेंजमेंट. सो दैट द क्वेश्चन सेज दैट, ओके, रीड द गिवन इंफॉर्मेशन केयरफुली एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चंस दैट फॉलोज. दैट देयर आर 11 फ्रेंड्स. नो द थिंग इज गिवन, देयर आर 11 फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द मेंशन हियर, एंड द नेम ऑफ द फ्रेंड्स आर गिवन. ओके, दिस वन आर सिटिंग इन द फर्स्ट रो ऑफ द स्टेडियम एंड वॉचिंग द क्रिकेट मैच. ओके, ऑल ऑफ देम आर sitting in the first row. That means this is a question of a linear arrangement and there are 11 friends. So let's construct 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and the 11th position. Now, if all of them are sitting in the first row of the stadium and watching the cricket match, that means all of them are facing in the same direction. So let's assume everyone is facing in this direction, which is your north direction. Now, as per the statement given that the T is to the immediate left of P, T is to the immediate left of P and third to the right of U. Now, according to this statement, you don't know what is the position of T, don't know what is the position of P, you don't know what is the position of U. So, it is better pick those statements whose particular position is fixed. So let's see the second one. Second one says that B is the immediate neighbor of M and M is third to the left of S. Again, no fixed position is given. Let's move to the third statement. M is second to the right of Q, who is at the one of the ends. Okay, M is second to the right of Q, who is at the one of the ends. So Q is at one of the ends. So that means either Q would be here or Q would be here. But when you read the statement again, it says that M is the second to the right of Q. That means if you place Q here and the Q is facing in north direction, second right will be in this side. Now, in this side there is a no position, so that means this position will be halt. So this case will be neglected. So that means M is second to the right of Q. That means the position of M will be here, which is a second to the right of Q. Now, as per the things, you have the position of Q and M. Let's see where this thing is given. M is given here. That means you have to pick the statement number second from this one. Statement number second says that V is the immediate neighbor of M. Okay, V is the immediate neighbor of M. That means from here two cases will be arise. That means either V could be here or V could be here. So let's construct the second line with same number of persons. This one is Q, this one is M, this one is your V, this one is your case number 1, this one is your case number 2. Okay, let's see, V is the immediate neighbor of M. This statement has been completed, so underline this one. And N, okay, V is the immediate neighbor of M and N. That means this case will be neglected because V is the neighbor of M and N. If you place V here, you cannot place the N here. So that means N is here. This case is neglected. Let's erase this one. North direction. Okay. So and N. Okay. For till here this is completed. And third to the left of S. Okay. So position of V is third to the left of S. That means S would be here. So 1, 2, 3. No, S would be here. So 1, 2, 3. Third to the left of S. So far two statements have been completed. Now, as you already know, you have know the position of this one and this one. Okay, let's see the another statement. Okay, T is the immediate left of P and third to the right of Q. Okay, T is immediate left of P. That means T and P will be like this one, and T is third to the right of U. That means 1, 2 and 3rd. So U would be here. So this was the position. So let's take Let's see where this position will be fulfilled. T and P should be near to each other. So this position could not be filled here. These positions could not be filled here. This could be filled here. So we have to place here T. We have to place here P. Now, as per the condition, U should be here. So this will fulfill our condition. So let's move to the next part. Last statement. The last statement says that R is sitting next to the right of P. R is sitting next to the right of P. So right of P is here and R is here. Okay. P is second to the right of O. So this position is for O. So let's see whose left, whose position is left. Q is filled, M is filled, V is filled, N is filled, O is filled, S is filled, T, P, R, U. So position left is W. So this one is our final diagram to this question. Now, as we have constructed the diagram, we have to go for the questions. Let's see the questions of this part. Okay, the arrangement of the person will be like this one, as I have already made them. Now, the question number one says that, who is sitting in the center of the row? So, who is sitting in the center of row? You have to count the numbers. And this one is your U. So, U is our answer, who is sitting at the center of the row. As you can see that there are 11 persons, so position of U would be 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 position is U. 5 is there, 5 is there, so U is sitting in the center of the row. Question is who are sitting, okay, listen to this one, who are sitting to the right of S? So right of S, who are sitting? O, T, P, R. So our answer will be O, T, P, R. So question number third, which of the following statement is true with respect to the above arrangements? Okay, there are three persons sitting between P and S. So P is here, S is there, number of persons sitting is 2. So this could not be followed. W is between M and V. Okay, W is between M and V. This could not follow. This will be discarded. N is sitting between V and U. N is sitting between V and U. So V is there, U is there, and N is sitting between them. So that means our answer will be option number third. Okay, so question number four says that who are the immediate neighbors of T? So immediate neighbors of T are O and P. These are the immediate neighbors of T. So our answer will be O and P. So this one is our right answer. Okay, so thank you class. This is all for the day. Thank you very much.